So welcome with me again on this show, The Professional. And today I'm going to share with you on letter S within the word professional. And this S, I'm going to make it stand for self-control. Self-control. I'm sure you must have had a few people tell you once or twice, they say, exercise control. Why not take control of the situation? You know, take charge, exercise some patience and all of that. This is a very, very important point. If you are a professional, ability to exercise control and to understand what it is to take charge of the situation is critical if you are going to be a high-end professional. And this is my story. So I was involved in a business. I was a senior manager, and it was my idea that we had end-of-year retreat, business retreat, so we could strategize and think about, well, review the past year and think about strategies for success and growth in the outer years. So we had this retreat, beautiful hotel we went to. All the managers were about 11, 12 senior managers in this establishment, and the business review continued. Now, before then, before this review, I'd been having some tussles with my boss in relation to staff welfare issues and all. I was supposed to manage business operations in this business. And so I can't even remember what I said. I'm sure I must have made a provocative statement, unintentional, as far as I thought. The next I saw was some kind of rage from my manager. He was so angry, he was livid, he was shaking. I'd never seen that kind of behavior in a corporate setting all my life. I was both scared and angry, and then I didn't know how to manage the situation. So I started saying, I'm sorry, sir. I'm sorry. And then the other members of the team, because we were the two most senior managers, other members of the team were quiet, almost like. And then he stood up and he started yelling and ranting and talking and all of that. All of this took like 5 minutes or so. I was embarrassed as well, because I'd worked in other organizations and I would never have expected this kind of outburst in a corporate setting, for crying out loud. I was visibly embarrassed. Right there, after a little while, I think he realized he had overreacted, and there was this quiet. And then he goes, I'm sorry, can we take a break? That was a welcome break. So we all left, everybody. Once they all stood up, I didn't know if to stand or sit or cry or weep or yell or whatever. But I recall that I had my notebook. I wrote in my notebook, my job ends now. I am out of this business today, out now. So imagine how the business review went. Because by the time we returned, I never will pray for a repeat of that kind of drama. So I kept quiet. I was supposed to be driving the business review, but it was like, yes, Of course, we closed down. Guess what? Your guess is right. I was out of the business. So let's bring it back home in terms of how we react. Because when we talk about self-control, we're meaning to say you must understand who you are. You must understand who you are, your strengths, your weaknesses, your behavior, the tendencies you have, what you're prone to doing if X and Y do happen to you. You should know yourself. This is the very first intelligence that any professional manager should display. So when you don't know understand yourself and you don't know yourself, when people behave and they act in a manner, it can provoke you to exhibiting some unsocial behavior. I mean, because just imagine, play back the story I just mentioned to you. And I'm very sure on the basis of that reaction, my manager lost other members of the team. And he also lost respect. That's what happens. When you lose control, you lose self-respect. You lose some regard. It's going to take maturity for your team to actually take you back on the pedestal where they've held you. So are you the type that blows your top? You say, that's who I am. It just shows you're emotionally unintelligent. You don't want to be that. But you can work on it. Yeah, you can work on it deliberately. So know your limits, know the guides, know the guards, and put up certain safeguards that protect and defend you. There are behaviors that you can't put up as a professional. You can't. You simply can't do that. I recall also that in that meeting, that day in my heart, I was like, if this happened in some multinational organizations, this guy is going to be fired right away, right away. Yeah, that's what it is. So self-control is important, and it goes with you everywhere you are, incidentally, because this is your behavior. So at home, you will see those tendencies come up wherever you go. So you must take control of it, understand who you are. You may need counseling. You may need external help. You may need a coach. You may need anger management therapy and all of this. Nothing wrong in getting help. You need help to remain a professional. I hope you got something out of today. I'm hoping to talk with you again next time. See you soon. But go ahead, take control. Bye-bye.